11 billionaires who are models of frugality. If you had billions of dollars, what would you do? Would you travel on a private jet and visit the top vacation spots in the world? Are you going to buy the fashionable clothes you've always dreamed of? Will you move into a million-dollar mansion and own numerous luxury cars? So much money to spend! However, this is the opposite of what happens in reality. You'll surely get the shock of your life when Brightside gives you a peek into the lives of the world's richest of the rich, who are surprising models of frugality. Before we reveal these billionaires, hit the subscribe button and turn on the little notification bell. Now you'll always be the first to see our new fun and interesting videos on the bright side of life. Let's start the countdown. Number 11. Charles Ergen. Charles Ergen is worth about $10.8 billion. He is a self-made billionaire who started his business empire by selling C-band satellite dishes from the back of a truck in 1980. That business is now Dish Network, and he is the chairman and co-founder. Ergen is also the chairman of EchoStar, a leading worldwide provider of satellite communication solutions. Ergen is a total control freak and runs his business with an iron fist. According to BusinessInsider.com, Ergen is known to publicly berate executives to ensure the company's goals are met. He also requires and ensures that his employees clock in with fingerprint scanners. Ergen prefers a lunch of sandwiches in a brown paper bag over five-star restaurant dishes. On his business travels, he shares rooms with his colleagues and never flies first class. Number 10. Carlos Slim Helu. Meet Mexico's richest man, Carlos Slim Helu, with an amassed wealth of over $64 billion. He currently owns more than 200 companies and has stakes in construction, retail, mining, and real estate companies. He also owns 17% of the New York Times. Carlos built his conglomerate, known as Slimlandia, by buying and investing in Mexican companies during the country's debt crisis in 1982. He buys multi-million dollar mansions, but Carlos is settled in the same six-bedroom house he's owned for more than 40 years. The self-made billionaire doesn't have high-end tailored suits, preferring to buy most of his clothes from one of his retail outlets. The telecoms tycoon is tech-savvy himself, but he also prefers good old-fashioned pen and paper over a computer. In fact, he asks his advisors to write down their briefings on one sheet of paper. Number 9. Jim Walton. Jim Walton is the youngest son of Sam Walton, the founder of Walmart, the world's largest retailer. This man has a company that earns $500 billion from its 12,000 stores worldwide, runs a bank with assets of more than $16 billion, has a net worth of around $43 billion, and can get anything he wants with a snap of his fingers. Jim operates the family business from the upstairs floor of a plain old brick building in Bentonville, Arkansas. His home is also located near his office, where the first Walmart store opened in 1970. Jim is hands-on with all the dealings of the family's companies, just like his father. According to former Walmart CEO David Glass, Jim wants to get things done and always puts in very long hours. Number 8. John Caudwell. The now-retired co-founder of the United Kingdom's largest mobile phone distributor, Phones For You, has a personal net worth of $2.4 billion. Phones For You wasn't that successful in its first 2 years. However, the company made a breakthrough in 1991 because of John's entrepreneurial spirit. When John sold the company in 2006, it was reportedly selling 26 phones a minute. He is still involved in various property, aviation, and wealth management businesses, but his primary focus is his philanthropic deeds. John is one of the signatories to the Giving Pledge, and he is committed to giving over half of his wealth to charitable causes. This is in addition to his own foundations, Caudwell Children and Caudwell Lime Co. Charity. Before his retirement, John rode his bike 14 miles to and from work every day. He told Forbes magazine that he doesn't need Savile Row suits and prefers to buy from the British retailer Marks & Spencer. John doesn't have a taste for expensive wines, and he even cuts his own hair. Number 7. Amancio Ortega. One of the richest men in Europe also holds the title of the wealthiest retailer in the world. It is none other than Amancio Ortega, the owner of the European fashion chain Zara. This brand is one of the subsidiaries of Inditex, a company he co-founded with his ex-wife, Rosalia Mara, in 1975. In 2017, he surpassed Bill Gates and Jeff Bezos by being the richest man in the world, but he fell to the third spot within 48 hours of it being announced. Nonetheless, Ortega and his fortune are worth over $68 billion. He is also a self-made billionaire who dropped out of school. The multi-billionaire is more often seen on the factory floor checking new products with his designers than cooped up inside a spacious private office. Ortega is never seen wearing his own brand, Zara, preferring a plain uniform of a blue blazer, white shirt, and gray pants. He lives in a discreet apartment building with his second wife, Flora, in the same small Spanish town where he grew up. Number 6. David Cheriton. If you study computer engineering at Stanford, you've probably met the billionaire professor, David Cheriton. His net worth is over $6 billion, and he initially made his fortune by being one of the very first investors in Google. He is not only a tech-savvy professor, but also a shrewd businessman. Cheriton cuts his own hair, flies economy class, and has lived in the same home for over 35 years. He's splurged twice in his lifetime. The first time was when he bought a 2012 Honda Odyssey. The second was when he took a vacation to Maui to windsurf. After that, he considered himself spoiled and was upset because of the money he'd spent. When he dines in an expensive restaurant, he saves half of each meal for the next day. And he claims that he reuses tea bags. Whoa! Number 5. Azim Premji. One of his employees anonymously said that Azim Premji makes Uncle Scrooge look like Santa Claus. Premji owns the third largest information technology and outsourcing company in India. He did the unthinkable when he took the reins of Wipro Limited from his father and transformed the family's cooking oil business into a software and outsourcing company. Now, his net worth is over $17 billion. Amazing, huh? But what's even more amazing is his insane spending habits. He prefers to fly coach and drives an old Toyota Corolla. The czar of Indian IT monitors how many toilet paper rolls are used by his employees and reminds them to turn off the lights before leaving the office. He is also known to give away tens of millions of dollars to charities. Number 4. Mark Zuckerberg. Even if Facebook lost almost $17 billion and he was grilled by Congress, Mark's net worth is over $68 billion. Plus, he's still included in the Forbes and Bloomberg lists of the world's top 10 billionaires. Zuckerberg drives a $30,000 manual transmission Volkswagen, and he's content with a uniform of a t-shirt, jeans, and sneakers. In 2011, he splurged a little when he bought a $7 million house in Palo Alto. In the backyard of that house, he married his longtime girlfriend, Priscilla Chan. Mark and his wife announced in 2015 that they would donate 99% of their Facebook shares. Zuckerberg is also a philanthropist and contributes billions of dollars to charitable causes. Number 3. Warren Buffett. The Oracle of Omaha has a net worth of over $85 billion. He is one of the most successful investors in the world, yet he does everything to live below his means. Buffett is the current chairman and CEO of Berkshire Hathaway, which is a collection of around 60 companies including Geico, Duracell, and Dairy Queen. Despite his staggering wealth, Buffett prefers a simple and frugal life. He still lives in the same 6,000-square-foot, 5-bedroom house he bought for $31,500 in 1958 in Omaha, Nebraska. Instead of dining in 5-star restaurants, Buffett buys a cheap breakfast at McDonald's. He is also committed to giving away 99% of his wealth to charity, and he launched the Giving Pledge with Bill Gates in 2010. Number 2. Bill Gates. Gates's net worth is around $95 billion, and he is ranked as the second richest man in the world. Gates is a computer genius and savvy entrepreneur. Although he is no longer the CEO and chairman of Microsoft, Gates remains a board member. Today, he is more drawn to his own charity, the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. His friend Buffett doesn't own a $10 wristwatch like Gates does, but he has similar views on fast food joints. In fact, they shared a bite at Hong Kong McDonald's, and he recalled that Buffett paid for the meal with coupons. But now the business moguls won't have to collect coupons because they're the proud owners of McGold cards, granting them free McDonald's food for life. Priceless. Number 1. Jeff Bezos. With a net worth of over $157 billion, Bezos is the founder and CEO of Amazon.com Incorporated, the owner of the Washington Post, and the owner of an aerospace company called Blue Origin. He was one of the pioneers of e-commerce when he started Amazon.com in his own garage. Bezos initially sold books online, later expanding to a wide range of products and services. In terms of frugality, Bezos flaunts it to the world. He isn't a member of the Giving Pledge, but he donates to other foundations like the nonprofit TheDream.us. Reportedly, he drives a Honda Accord, and his desk at Amazon is made from a wooden door. Which frugal billionaire inspired you the most? Tell us in the comments. Don't forget to hit the like button and share this video with your friends.